These pineapples are basically local. I'd rather the avocados. They are local, they are produced by our people, but the export ones are called Hass. Mm-hmm. Those ones are grown on the
large scale.
Then the pumpkins, then we have the onions are also locally produced, quite a big quantity. These ones are also exported these days because the aroma they bring. When you cut it, you start crying right away. They are very,
very pungent.
Yeah, very pungent and all that.
Fantastic.
So, yeah, we do export these as well.
What sort of volumes do you think you'll be able to do potentially of these?
For our local market?
Yeah.
I think we do, every day we do 200 kilos of this.
Yeah.
So meaning that in 10 days we've done 2 tons. Yeah, and this is going to grow because they are putting Serena on board.
Yeah, so that's the like big local hotel.
Yeah, this is a big local hotel, and we are also adding Total.
Mm-hmm.
So
you could be doing that for the north for the oil.
Total, we are going to be feeding 3,000 people.
Mm, fantastic.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
So our market base is actually going to triple what we have already.
Excellent. So you know, with the right sort of fertilizers, how will that affect your yields?
Of course, with the fertilizers, our farmers will be able to produce the quality we need, and then to sustain the demand, because once you start the demand,
you're not going to be able to fulfill it.
Definitely. Yeah. We can't sustain the demand, then you find that you are not able to meet your orders, and then, you know.
So you think there's enough local buyers at the moment for a lot of these products, but you also want to start to move towards an export industry.
At the moment, we're not producing enough for the local market.
So
as far as enough market, it is there. But locally, Ugandan produce is not only consumed in Uganda.
Yeah.
Rwanda gets most of their agriculture produce here because they are hilly. They don't grow as much as
they can't do the vegetables.
South Sudan, everything comes from here because it's semi-desert. They don't produce as much as we do.
So what do you think is going to be the new market? I mean, also obviously there's East Congo as well, and I know that that's going to be a great market, but things like South Sudan, they're opening up.
Yeah.
That's going to be a huge market for you.
Definitely. It has always been, apart from this period when they have been at war, but South Sudan has always been the biggest consumer of Ugandan produce because they eat everything they eat from Uganda. It's grown in Uganda. Then Kenya also goes through scarcity periods and they come here for everything.
That's true. There's always a short.
And then of course there is the big export market of Ugandan produce, Dubai, taking a lot of things, Asian countries. China has started to take quite a lot of Ugandan.
I think also for you as well, especially things like coffee and maize. I think there's a big market for you in South Africa as well.
Yeah.
Particularly, because I mean, there's always been a shortage in Southern Africa.
We've exported to Zimbabwe. Maize.
Yeah.
They always get from Malawi, but Malawi gets out of it, and then they come to East Africa.
They always
come to Uganda and take it. So the Southern African bloc has always bought produce from there.
So you're pretty excited about this pilot.
Yeah, I am. Very, very excited.
Yeah, excellent.
It will just give our farmers more opportunities. It will grow them because they will have to be sure that there is a market for what they are growing. That's what has been a setback for most farmers. Mm. The soils are good. If you add fertilizer, the produce is the quality of the product. The produce is very good, but they fear if I grow 10 acres, where will I have the market?
Yeah, that's right.
So if our partnership is going to link the markets
with
productivity, with the trainings we'll be giving them, and then it will just blow up.
And do you think they're going to have a problem understanding how the cryptocurrency works in this variable?
Since the coin, the Bitcoin and all that have been introduced in Uganda already, people already have a concept of how it works. So it's all a matter of having a small team of trainers who will be able to pass this message into the local language to them. They will catch up quite easily because it is basically it's basically a trade. You get coins, you get this. So
why wouldn't they even have to do it?
There is the easiest language to understand is trade. So everything you trade,
anything that helps you trade, people will going to understand.
People will understand it.
Cool. So, and you think the sort of levels of interest rate that we could be charging are the sort of levels at about 10, 12, 13% around that sort of level is what people could sustain?
Yeah, people can sustain them because they're used to 28% by our banks here. And some of them are, even with those high interest rates, been successful.
Yeah.
Others have failed because they're high.
So if you
give them something better, obviously, it will be a bonus.
So, well, I think what we're going to try and do, which is why I'm excited about working with you, is to start working with the farmers and then working with the best of them so that others can see first of all. So we're going to do little pilots,
yeah.
and then a few farmers succeed,
yeah.
then people can watch them succeed, and then they're going to be able to do it.
Definitely. Ugandan farmers trust fellow farmers more than the marketeers.
Yeah.
So even if you had the best marketeers who are not farmers, they will not pick up what you want. So if we did that pilot with a few farmers, these farmers will spread the word more than any advertisement you can make.
Absolutely.
Yeah, because these farmers will believe failed farmers. If so-and-so succeeded, what am I waiting for? I should just go on.
Okay, just keep going on to it.
Yeah.
Brilliant.
Yeah.